Okay, in this video I'm going to talk to you about credential, how to create a credential. But firstly let me explain to you what is the credential. Okay, what happens is that whenever you create a window, logging with the window authentication mode, actually it has access to the windows and other things that are required via user. But what happens when you have created a login in the SQL server and you are actually and mapped it to the SQL server user, creating a login in the SQL server and mapping it to the SQL, that user doesn't have an access outside the SQL server. So in order to have a access to the SQL server outside, what you need to do is that for a user to have the access to the Windows service outside the SQL server, what you need to do is to create a credential. Now, how do you create a credential? Before creating a credential, let's go and actually try and create a user in the SQL server and login in the SQL server. Let's first create a login and then we will map the login to the SQL server user. Okay, let's go to the Northwind. Okay, now before going to the Northwind, okay, let's come down to the security part of it. Okay, and actually let's create a new login name. Let's say we will give a login name, we'll use a SQL Server authentication, assuming that we are actually Neptune. Okay, and we'll give it a password. This is where I am going to map the credential. As you can see, I have to put the credential and actually check the checkbox here. Right now I have not created the credential, so I will leave it as it is and just I will create a login right now here and I will click OK. And there we are, I have created a login. As you can see, here is our login. Okay, now I will add a user with the same name to the database where I want this login to have access to. Okay, in this case let's take it as PUPS2000. I will go again to the security and I will go to the user. There it is. Now I can actually add a new user. Okay, and let's go and find the login name that I just created. That is Neptune. So let's go and find where it is. Here it is. Okay, and I just created a Neptune and click OK. And I'll put the same name here also. And I have a new user because I have created it. I will give it to the database reader writer and I am just going to leave it as it is. Okay, and I'm going to click OK. Now my basic idea of creating this login was to actually show you how to use the credentials. Now remember, a credential can have a multiple logins associated with it, but a login can have only one credential. Okay, now before going anywhere else, let's collapse this thing. Now we'll go back to the security. Now in security again we'll go to the new credential. Now I will go into the credential and select a new credential and it will actually show me a screen for creating a credential. there we are. I am going to type the name bin credential. Now I have to identify both the window login. Remember that thing. So I will go here, advanced, find now, and there may be the login, one of the login I would like to actually identify this thing, but I'm going to check this one and I'm going to click OK, and I'm going to give a password. For a simplicity word, I'll give just a 2-letter password, and I'm going to click OK. And before I click OK, I can always script it down to the new window to show you what the script would be. In the case, if you want to use a T-SQL command, and I'm going to say OK. Okay, as you can see, this is a T-SQL command actually that has been generated for creating a credential. It is identified by the login name, and the secret is a password. Actually, whenever it doesn't use the password, it uses secret in the reference to the password. Okay, now let's go down and see whether the credential has been created. Yes, it has been created. Now I have to go and map it to the SQL Server login that I created in the PUPS 2000. So I will go to the database again. I could have also done it with the SQL or T-SQL, but this is a better way of showing it to you. That would have been much more faster, but you would have never understood what it is. The probability is very high because it would just take only 2 commands and it would be done. Now I have a login, user login. Okay, this is a user Neptune. I have to go to the logins Neptune, go to the properties for the Neptune. Here we are. As you can see, I can map the credential here. Click here, and then I am going to select the bin credential, and I am going to click add. Once I have added it, then I can script it and see it to the new file. What syntax did it generate, or the SQL T-SQL statement or SQL? Okay, and I am going to click OK. As you can see, it has generated this alter login Neptune. Okay, add credential, bin credential, and go. And this is how we have actually created credential for the SQL Server login. Okay, that's it. I will just end it here.